black screen.
All right, can everybody see the loading screen?
Chad?
Yeah. All right. Like, is the chat still going in yours?
Yeah.
Oh, did they leave? Kyle, they left?
They left a decent while ago.
They left at the end of the first game. It's still going?
All right, so can everybody see the loading screen? Just making sure the stream is working properly.
They have Mountain Jurious.
Well, I mean...
Oh, scumbag Lang Jai with no skin.
Oh, GG.
ER Lang Jai, now off the team. No skin, GG.
I think they're just not using the chat.
Shoutouts to I'm Yuna for going MF with the cool skin.
The cool skin, by the cool skin he means? Oh,
oh, it's agent. 45 seconds into the game. And, oh, Omumu spotted.
Oh, 45 seconds into game, ER's
ER's still
invade.
Looking to be very aggressive.
Oh, their invade on the red was spotted. They might be looking to swing up to the blue. Or they're probably going to defend from a counter invade. No, it looks like they're all business. They're going for that blue. They will get spotted out if they walk right in. Diana should see.
Whoa,
oh, wow.
Diana not reacting.
So this could be bad. Okay, she has to burn the flash. Misfortune blew her ignite, but that's not too big a deal.
That was extremely...
That was just really bad on... That was just really bad on Diana's part. Because she was walking around in that area of grass where you can't see around the corner.
Yeah.
I mean, if she was just standing there in the spot you're supposed to be in, you'd see them coming right out of the bush and you can just run away. And either way, Flash probably...
Oh, what the?
Oh, we have a disconnect by Darius. All right, so here we go. Let's bring up the chat and see what's going on. I see some not good and a bunch of question marks.
All right, Elite again. Redemption not aware that Darius disconnected.
All the jokes by his teammates. Anyway, judging from that level 1 ER, even though they did not have a great level 1, they still wanted to go for that invade, showing that they're still that super aggressive team from game 1. But this time, only one flash was blown, only an ignite was blown. So it's not too bad. Alright, so let's look at their item starts. Akali started Rejuvenation Bead, 2 wards, and 4 pots. I have no idea what to make of that start. It's very interesting. That seems to be... borderline trolling to me, but what do I know? Alright, so Moon was gone with the machete, 5 pots. Alright, here we go. Play will be resumed. Alright, Lulu started with a pink ward. So that should be interesting.
That means they're looking to make some early plays in bottom. Oh, here we go. Thresh and Katarina.
Looks like they're trying to disrupt them.
Oh, I'm not sure why they exhausted
Lulu.
That was
an interesting move. That was disruptive, but one of their teammates wasn't there to help follow up.
Yeah, if Tristana was there, that could have been a kill.
So, exhaust blown for no reason. No joy out of it. Did send Lulu back, so Misfortune will be 2v1 for a little while now. Looks like Jax used Counter-Strike against Darius, and Darius gives no fucks about that.
Darius just slapped him right back.
Yeah, so you're going to be looking for Darius to be using a lot of that Q just to cut Jax off, get that passive on him, get that damage on him, force him to burn pots. But Jax did go for that, what is it, 7 health potion, 2 mana potion start with a ward. So I had lots of wards starting on top of Elite Redemption's side, whereas the only wards that were starting on Kamaka's side were on the support. So Diana has gone back already. Despite only clearing red and a small camp.
She doesn't know that her blue is still up.
Well, she'll be in for a nice surprise when she goes to clear the blue timer. Alright, so Akali, I guess I can kind of understand the rejuvenation bee, but what is she going to build it into? A Warmox? That'll be interesting. I mean, for all we know, she could be trolling me and she'll build a Tiamat out of it. It's also a possibility. So, typical Amumu first clear, you do get kind of low. He used all his potions.
I'm sure that that little skirmish didn't help.
Yeah, it didn't help any. It's probably why he was so low, but he'll be able to take the Wraith Camp easily, probably hit level 4 from it. Then he'll go back and most likely buy boots. If not boots, he'll go for a Spirit
Darius
Stone.
Darius getting low.
Darius on the worst end of all these trades. He did start Cloth 5 and is only now burning a health potion. So he is ahead in the sustain department for now.
He needs to be a little more liberal with those potions though before he dies.
Yeah, because Jax does have Ignite. And he will hit 5 before Darius. Which means a little more pain on whichever skill he's maxing. Yeah, most likely Empower.
Yeah, Kamaka's bottom lane really struggling right now. Hopefully Diana can put some pressure on them pretty soon. Stuff again.
Alright, so looking at the CS matchup, the junglers are even with the difference about 1 or 2 to be expected. Amumu's sitting in that top lane bush with the red buff looking to gank Darius. I am not so sure how this is going to turn out. I don't think they'll get a kill. At most, they'll burn a flash. Yep, so there's the flash. Oh, wow. So yeah, Jax needs to leap away before he takes another tower shot. So, I mean, that's good. He burned his flash, but...
Darius getting a little payback.
He's getting a little payback for all that spinning he's been doing. Tristana Thresh really suffering against that Lulu Misfortune. Despite Misfortune being 2v1 for a little while. So the much stronger mechanic still showing in all lanes. Oh my. Akali has nearly 4 times the CS of Katarina.
Dude, that's not good at all. Although it might just be the player is not that good at CSing, because that was the Garen from last game.
This is true. And here we go, another gank from Amumu. This one is pretty free, seeing as he's got... Oh, wow.
Oh, he missed it.
So a slight misplay by Amumu there. They put a little more damage on Darius. But the wave will push, so Amumu will most likely leave to farm up his jungle and try to get to a quick level 6. So looking at the ward coverage, there's a lot of ward coverage for Elite Redemption. It's all in the river, so they'll see
wherever the jungler pops up.
Whereas the wards for we missed the first blood, but there went Katarina. That was probably bound to happen, seeing the way the CS was going. That and Akali is 7, so she had her ultimate for a while now. So the gold gap will further widen in mid. Let's see what item that Akali returns to lane with once she goes back. When we're clearing his camps, I think he hit level 5 with the golem, so he'll probably be hitting level 6 after he takes his blue buff plus a few camps. Diana is just gobbling up that CS in mid since it's free. nice bit of experience. That was a weird rocket jump from Tristana, which made her miss 2 out of the 3 CS. Alright, so I mean, Elite Redemption went back to buy. Not much to say right now. Again, the ward coverage for blue team Kamakas is not existent, really. There's one near the enemy race, that's fine, but I don't think it's deep enough to be meaningful.
I guess the good news is that they're not falling as far behind this game.
Yeah, the gold lead is only 2k. It hasn't snowballed like it did last game. Darius needs to not get hit by that. Alright, so what did Akali buy? She bought a Giant's Belt and a Hextech Revolver. Still no boots, but... yeah, I guess his mind says you don't need boots when you're just going to man fight both of them. Mumu just idling by bottom tower looking to gank since he got his Curse of the Sad Mummy. This will be interesting. So Lulu MF looking to push out the wave. Omumu should be getting into the lane bush. Jax escaping death. Alright, so they do not know Amumu's there. But Tristan and Thresh have been playing quite far back. It's a good pull on.
Oh, misses the box. Momo flies into the box.
That is death on both of them.
Yep, good curse of a sad mummy.
Well, it still picked up both of them. I'd rather have seen her just use bullet time just to pick up both quickly. Oh, now she's bullet timing the wave. I would rather have seen bullet time used earlier so that Misfortune got both of the kills instead of one of them winding up on the support. But maybe they wanted the gold split up that way. Alright, so Darius backing after his attempt at a kill on Jax.
It's actually good to see that Darius is basically even with Jax.
Yep, CS is even, no kills, no assists on either one of them.
Yeah, and despite getting camped, too.
Alright, so Diana is ahead in CS, but Amumu has those two assists from bottom. So they should be relatively even in gold. Amumu should be slightly ahead. There, here comes a dive on mid. Oh, not dive. Yeah, it was a dive. So good dive, good coordination. Thresh and Tristana not saying anything. I mean, they did die. The enemy team did go back, so I guess you couldn't really warn them. So now Kamaka's putting up more wards in their own jungle.
Extremely defensive wards.
Yeah, very defensive wards. They have... oh, there's a Mumu taking CS. They have literally no offensive wards at all into the enemy jungle to see where the enemy jungler is. So they are basically in the dark about Amumu's movements.
Diana really needs to pay top a visit.
Diana needs to make her presence known. She needs to gank top. Gank top or gank mid. I know it's going to be hard to gank an Akali who's already 5 times the CS of your mid. Yeah, now's not the time to be ganking when there's a big wave at the tower. So she shows, and that's going to give Akali free reign to roam wherever she wants. The defensive wards are gone for Kamakas. So Akali will probably be looking to... good kill by Darius.
The passive picks up the kill.
Good kill by Darius, getting himself a lead now. As I said, Akali looking to be in the trap. Diana is going to find Akali, and there's probably going to be a big fight going on right here. Or not. I guess Akali was not paying attention at all. But that bush is pink, so they'll be getting rid of Diana's ward that they just put in there, and Akali will take her leave. Oh, he's circling back in. She might be looking to dive.
Oh.
No, this... I don't think she's gonna die. Oh, wow.
Oh, good ultimate.
Good ult by Triss. That was a bad dive by Akali. She had to flash, and they got one kill out of it. But now Miss Fortune is alone. She's split off from everybody else. She needs to leave. Alright, so it's a four-man dive for one kill. Oh, three-man dive for one kill against four people, so it's still in Elite Redemption's favor.
Man, Katarina sitting at 28 CS?
Yep, as compared to Akali's 110, and she's 102, whereas Kat is 020. So the gold disparity in mid is staggering. It's a 2.1k difference. So Akali just had her way with Katarina, and now she's just going to roam wherever she wants because Katarina cannot afford to leave lane to try and stop her.
Yeah, they're fighting again on top.
Alright, so Mumu's walking up towards top, but a ward did spot him out. Darius should be cautious, probably back off. Yep, there we go.
Yeah, Mumu's trying to come extinguish the one hope that Kamakas have right now.
Oh, Katarina's backing on a pink ward. Or being... I have no idea what he's doing, but he... They're crossing tons of wards everywhere. So that one ward near the enemy wraiths did help. It did spot Amumu out. It'll spot him again. And they're fighting. Katarina just got chunked. How many marks does she still have? Oh, you can't select her, I guess. I want to know how... Show the target frame. I want to see how many marks she still had. Alright, so she used... Okay, she only used one on that dive, and it took off nearly two-thirds of Katarina's health. Rampage. There's a kill on bottom.
Rampage.
There's a kill on bottom. Lulu did use her ult. Misfortune ulted the wave down at bottom, so it's a free wave onto the blue tower.
Oh, here we go. Here comes Diana. And misses the Q.
That was not a good way to initiate the gank. Akali could have just fought right there and possibly killed both of them, but did not want to take that risk. Alright, so purple team taking down Dragon and a bottom tower. And they're going for the invade right here. Diana throwing her crescent at them, letting her presence be known. Yeah, Katarina just needs to leave. They know that Amumu and... They're fighting again. Darius did not ult. I don't know. I think he just let a possible kill get away right there without ulting. Darius is ahead by 5. It is in his favor.
It was all the summoners on both sides.
I mean, it is in his favor, but he still should have ulted just to try and kill him. He needs to carry his team. And Thresh is about to feed another kill right here. Nope. Akali stealthing under the tower. Okay. Oh, there goes mid tower. Tristana roaming up to mid for whatever reason. I mean, Tristana should not be here. Katarina's already far enough to...
Darius.
So Darius has come to mid, but he's already used his pull. They're going to get away scot-free. And Miss Fortune is just going to get more free farm at bottom. Jax will be able to put a little bit of damage on the tower, but he won't be able to do much damage to it because Darius is already headed back up.
It's mostly just the CS Darius is missing.
I would like to see Darius spin more to try and see. Oh, Thresh. That was... Thresh is about to die. Yep.
That was really awkward.
I have no idea what he was doing right there. Darius is about to get Counter-Strike. So I don't think he should be man fighting. Yeah,
he should be fighting way more.
And he does have the speed boost from his passive. He should be looking to put damage and kite. No, he's not dead yet. See, now he could potentially kill him. He's got ult. Now he's dead. Now he's dead.
Saving his ult too much.
So saving his ult, I mean, that other potential kill that he let get away, that could have been the difference right there in that fight too.
Did he try to dunk right there?
No, he did not.
At the very end, it seemed like he tried to dunk.
No,
right there.
He didn't move. He did a spin, and I think it was not the jump to dunk.
And another dive resulting in a kill. And this game is pulling away.
Yep, Curse of the Sad Mummy and Bullet Time being used. Katarina not guaranteed to go. Oh, yep. Use the flash, use the.
Oh, did Diana not have her pull? She should have pulled her out of that.
Yeah. Like mid-flight, she should have just pulled her.
If she did, probably was not expecting it for whatever reason, did not react. So what was a slightly close game is now being snowballed into a 9.4k gold lead. And it's only going to get worse because the blue team just isn't doing what they need to do to come back right now. They should just group up and try to pick people off, seeing as Elite Redemption is content with just letting the split pushing and laning phase keep going pretty much. And they need to try and do what they did in mid, try to group up and pick people off, while Elite Redemption wants to keep splitting up to get more farm and push down towers. And Katarina's up here with Darius, but I'm not sure what they're going to do because Jax and Akali just left. Misfortune, free to push bottom tower, all five members. No, four members near mid and only one headed to her at bottom. Imune is probably looking to just take that last creep and leave with her prize. Thresh would do well to not try and engage Misfortune right now, lest he die.
Tristana's within lantern distance, and so is Katarina, but he's not using it.
Enough should have just tried to fight right there once she hit the wall. Once she hit the wall of the box, she should have just fought.
Because that's some nice gold for their team.
Yep, so that's a good amount of gold. Where's the scoreboard? I believe that was a shutdown bonus.
Yeah, it was.
Yep. So they got that 500 gold. Akali trying to take red, did not succeed, but she should realize Diana has no mana. Yep, she did, so she decided to fight. It's only Thresh and Katarina. Akali, yep, Akali will just go after Katarina. Tristana did not react at all. Akali still looking to kill Katarina. I'm pretty sure Katarina is...
Uh-oh.
Not worth that much, but this is bad. She is probably dead. Here comes the dunk. Oh, that was a bad rocket jump. That's okay. They did get the shutdown bonus on Akali.
Yeah, that's the kind of things they need. They need
to pick people off when they get too overconfident like that. Or tunnel vision trying to get kills. And the gold lead is still really big. It's 10.4k. It's about to be bigger, seeing as Elite Redemption is going to get the dragon. Item builds we're looking at. We have Darius looking towards a frozen mallet. But Jax is looking for Warmogs after his Blade of the Ruined King. So there's going to be a big difference in damage right there. So that's a catch on to Katarina. Katarina did not make full use of the lantern. She didn't go anywhere, really.
Oh, Tristana didn't ult Lulu.
Yeah, Tristana did not ult Lulu. She used it on... Oh, wow. Needs to just... fight. No, he's just gonna hold him there for Katarina.
He used all his mana, he could have just dunked earlier. That would have taken off like all that life.
And Misfortune just won the old wild Thresh. Thresh forced to burn his flash even though he died anyway. He just got pinched right in his own jungle. I mean, it's 23 minutes into the game. Kamathas will probably just finish the game. Elite Redemption, just looking to end it. Kamathas will probably just play it out to the end because they really don't have anything to lose in this second game.
No point in surrendering because it's over if they do.
Ooh. Okay, Darius putting out some damage, but his team is just too weak. They can't. Oh wow! Thresh pulled Jax mid jump, and that really screwed Jax over.
Oh, this could be their chance.
Yep, this is their chance. Amumu is caught. He must have flash if he's running like that. Yep. But Diana flashes right after him.
Diana not giving up.
Yep, Diana picking up the kill. So that's good. They needed that. They need to stop chasing and just clear the wave. Misfortune goes back to bottom to free farm. That was a really weird pull by Thresh. Oh, wow.
Oh.
That was a good catch, but she's going to murder Thresh. Big body Darius blocking.
Nice play by Akali. Yeah,
good play by Akali. Picking up that kill. Thresh worth gold again. And this is all but over, seeing as Misfortune went back and only had two items, and all of a sudden she has a Black Cleaver now. Yep, she's got that Null Magic Mantle, piece of the GA. Got Warmogs completed on Jax, Warmogs on Akali. And we also have a Bulwark completed on Amumu. He has a Giant's Belt, probably looking to get Sunfire Cape or Spirit of the Ancient Golem.
Cat not even bothering to CS.
Yeah, Cat not even CSing, just dancing. He's probably resigned himself to his fate of losing this match. Oh, and Purple Team, making sure there is no comeback factor, went to Baron. And I just baited them, and that is a huge Amumu ult. No Misfortune bullet time, just attacking.
Tristana walks up just to waste her ultimate.
Oh, Tristana just walking up, waste the ultimate. So that's a 3-4-0. They're just going to take the easy Baron, and they will probably be looking to push down top to end the game. Akali is in there diving for that fourth kill. Does not want to dive against Darius, seeing as she probably won't be able to do anything to him.
Now the damage not working out in her favor there.
Alright, so we've got the Baron. Probably going to push down top. Amumu should just go with his team instead of going to clear his blue. They should just end the game already.
Here we go, four guys grouping up, but looks like ER is backing out.
Yep, four man top, but once they cleared that tower, they were already planning to go back. Spend their newfound gold. Support with almost 1,100. Amumu's got 1,100. Jax has 1,000. Let's see what they buy. So we've got a Kindle Gem on Lulu, Pickaxe on Jax, and another piece of the Sunfire Cape on Amumu. And we have a death cap on Akali. It's a very interesting choice. I would have liked to have seen Rylai's instead.
I don't know. At this point, it's probably better that people just blow up when Akali touches them.
Alright, so Misfortune with both pieces of the GA, but I did not think she will be given enough time to finish the GA. Elite Redemption clearing out the enemy resources and probably looking to end the game by pushing up into this middle lane. Oh, Misfortune splitting off from her team. Elite Redemption all split up. Four-man group by Kamakas. Katarina was still in the fountain. Now they have a five-man group up at top.
They should have stayed hidden behind that wall and tried to make a play.
Yep. It should have stayed hidden. Also would have liked to have seen oh wow.
Ooh.
Good Lulu ult.
They put down some good chain CC on Cully, but then the counter CC falls.
The counter CC came, and there's just too much damage output by the two carries on Elite Redemption, and that's a 5-0 ace, and they're probably just gonna end the game. Because they have a super minion wave in the base. So that will be a good game. 2-0 victory to Elite Redemption. The fan favorite Kamakas. Saved by the inhibitor coming back up, but they should take that down quick enough. Yeah, they took out the top inhibitor, so
that's
there goes.
Buy time for Cat and
Thresh. Cat, Thresh, and Tristana pop up, but just a little too late. So GG. Fan favorite Kamakas not out of the tournament. They are just in loser's bracket now.